Stay tuned after the episode for an exclusive look inside the world of Ash vs. Evil Dead.
And now the Starz original series, Ash vs. Evil Dead.
Some spell I can say to undo all this.
You have to bury it deep below the place where your journey began.
Just keep on breathing.
I've been wanting to get closer to you.
Well, hey there.
Hello.
So are you two together or
no? He's got a girlfriend though.
What the hell happened?
Your head grew another you.
Looking for me?
Time to die!
Easy, kids. No need to jump the gun here.
Yeah. Don't shoot the wrong guy, dummies.
Oh, you buying this shiny turd? This is the guy who killed Fisher. Come on, take him out. I did not. That guy killed Fisher. Take him down.
Well, of course he's gonna say that. He's a murderer.
Pablo, amigo, just kill the guy and I'll get you a piñata or whatever.
Subtle racism?
But not that subtle.
Hey, I'm a racist too. Asian babies creep me out. But unlike Mr. Imposter here, I know stuff about your past. Stuff that only you told me. Pablo, until you were 9, your best friend was a kitty cat.
Notorious C.A.T.
Anybody can figure that crap out. Kelly, when you were in junior high school, you told me you busted a stained glass window of a church.
By accident.
Then you punched a nun in the face.
Uh-huh. She was being so dramatic about that stained glass. And she hit me first.
Okay, look, just shoot us both.
What?
Yeah, it's the only way. That way this asswipe is dead, and I don't have to deal with this horse shit anymore.
Oh, come on.
All right.
Oh, no. Okay, how'd you know it was really me?
Well, first off, you're racist. But not against Asians.
Well, why would I be? They give such incredible massages with those teeny hands.
Also, you tried to take the easy way out. Total Ash move.
What? Come on.
The only person you're willing to lay down and die for is you.
Well, that's because I'm very important to me.
Yeah, we definitely shot the right one.
I'm reconsidering.
Still, I might have given my life for her. God, we would have made such a handsome couple.
So, how did that happen?
My asshole hand. It came back, grew another me. Same shit, different day. Things were going fine with Amanda too, but that went south. All because of that goddamn book.
No disrespect. You were the one who read from it.
No disrespect, Kelly. If you live in the past, you hurt the future. Now this book has some freaky weird power. The sooner it's 6 feet under, the better. First, we gotta deal with these bodies. We can't have hot and sexy coming back to ruin our day. And I say that with all due respect to her. Well, brains before beauty.
Hello!
Oh, shit. We got company. Happy campers coming at ya.
Hello?
Hey. What are you guys doing here?
Brad got us lost.
It wasn't my fault. The trees, you know, it's like the trail map just stopped making sense. Can we crash here, maybe?
In this tiny cabin? No. The three of us here, we kind of fill it up to capacity. Plus, there's a few dead bodies in there.
Dead animal bodies.
Right, because maybe we're veterinarians. Really bad ones.
We specialize in a very radical form of surgery.
Or we're just hunters.
I think the point is there's no room at the inn, so you guys might just have to beat it. Sorry.
But maybe we could just camp in the front yard.
Can you give us a second? Okay, look, there is no way in hell they're gonna stay here because they're gonna get possessed. Then they're gonna be on the night train to Philadelphia.
With stops in Choklahoma City and Miami.
Nice.
I thought you'd like that.
Oh, hey, sorry to break up your moment, but we can't just send them back into the woods. Who knows what else is out there?
It's a hell of a lot safer out there than here.
And you're just worried about the little sister.
Guns and chainsaw.
Yeah, I am. Her name's Heather, and she's super cute. I don't know much else about her.
That's all you have to know. Okay, look, you two are gonna take him the back way to Elk Rapids.
Man, what back way?
There's a trail right out behind the cabin. Goes to civilization, then get your asses back here because I need you. In the meantime, some of us have to slice and dice. Good luck.
So, change of plans.
Cool of you guys to show us the way out of here.
Oh, yeah, well, anything to get out of a house of dead animals, right?
Listen, I know you're not hunters or veterinarians, not normal ones anyway. What are you guys up to?
What? We're getting you and your family to Elk Rapids.
Okay, fine, it's a secret. You know what? If you didn't have a girlfriend, I'd find a way to get it out of you.
Whoa. What do you mean, girlfriend?
I heard you were seeing someone.
From who?
from her. Is it serious?
I'm not sure. You okay?
Yeah.
Chopping up my evil clone. Maybe someday that'll feel weird. On the wall. Fuck me.
To bury me is a mistake.
No. No, we are not having this conversation.
You should use me.
I already did that dance. It made my life a living hell.
Only because you're trying to fight me. Stop fighting, admit it. You're not all good either. Be smart for once. Use me.
No, you're taking a dirt nap.
Ash, if you bury me, you stop being a Superman and go back to being a stock boy.
No.
Yes.
Nope. Not this guy. I've got possibilities.
To do what? Have a family? Become president? Get rich? None of that's ever going to happen. I'm what makes you special.
Blah, blah, blah. Play's over, Shakespeare.
Amanda, I'm sorry for what I must do to you. I promise I'll be a gentleman and respect your modesty while I cut you into small pieces. Well, maybe just one last little peek at those... Oh, shit. Amanda?
You know what? I like the forest and the fog. It kind of glows.
Yeah. Day or night, there's always something beautiful out here. Even if it's hard for some people to see it.
Hey, I voted for Lake Havasu, okay?
So Heather just told me that I got a girlfriend?
That's weird.
Yeah. She said you told her that.
I did.
Why?
I don't think she's good enough for you.
What's wrong with her?
Come on, you know how crazy girls can be.
Yeah, I'm learning.
Look, Pablo, I'm sorry, okay? But it's not a good idea to get involved with someone right now.
What? Why?
Because life expectancy is real short out here. Just enjoy the beauty. And I don't want to have to deal with that aftermath. Neither should you.
That's not how I want to live.
Watch out! Stay back!
What is it? What is it?
It was just a... raccoon.
Ew.
Guys, what the hell?
You know, it makes for a real good eating.
I've never heard that before.
Oh, yeah. Makes a real robust and savory stew. We should keep moving. Come on.
Whoa, 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 whoa! Hang on, hang on! Let's look before we leap this time, huh?
Get out of the way, Brad.
Excuse me, but my husband works in forestry, and I think you should listen to him.
He needs to stand clear of the trees, all right?
Why, so you can shoot another innocent animal?
Hello, pussies!
Ash is supposed to chop you up!
Guess he can't do anything right.
Two. Hello, Kelly. Do you love me? Because I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Next hot stuff.
Leave her alone!
Ha ha ha!
Before you die, I want you to know there is no heaven. I'm gonna peel the skin off your pretty little face.
Get away from her!
It's time your loyalty to Ash got rewarded.
Don't trust her! She's lying!
The truth. The truth is, we can still be together if you want.
Well, I'd like that. But our time has not yet come. Did you really have to do that? Amateurs.
Who the hell is that?
My leg.
I'm almost done.
This isn't real. It can't be happening.
I wish you were right.
Better tell Goldilocks to shut her baby blues. This fairy tale's about to get real bloody.
Oh, jeez, just stop it. What are you doing?
It's okay. Listen, you gotta chop them up. Or else they could come back as something much worse.
Nothing is worse than this.
Trust me. Everything is worse than this. So who the hell are you and what do you want with Ash?
I'm the one who's gonna stop him turning more people into monsters.
What the hell are you talking about? Ash doesn't turn anyone into monsters. He fights them.
Yeah, he's the only one standing in their way. And me too. I stand in their way all the time.
Oh, yeah, he fights them, all right. He's still got that book, hasn't he? The Necronomicon? Because, you know, that is at the root of all this trouble. Listen. Amanda was my friend, too. It doesn't matter what Ash's intentions are. As long as he's got that book, a trail of dead bodies is gonna follow. So take me to him. Where's the book you stole from my family?
Easy, Nancy Drew. The hell you guys doing? Selling tickets?
She's a nobie. And she saved us from Fisher.
Well, not all of us.
Okay, all right. Well, number one, it's my book. Has been for 30 years. Number two, I'm on your damn property because I'm here to save a little something I call Earth.
You know what I've been doing these past 30 years? Cleaning up your messes so they don't destroy a giant thing that everyone calls the Earth. And what have you accomplished in all these years? You put a chainsaw on your stump? Congratulations.
You know, it's a lot harder than it looks. Name one other person you know that has a functioning chainsaw arm.
This has to stop. You've got the Necronomicon, and you need to give it to me, so where is it?
None of your beeswax. I will tell you this, though. Pretty soon it's going to be 6 feet under.
Oh, you're going to bury it.
Bet you Bippy. I found that out during a drug-fueled trip.
So your entire plan to save the world comes courtesy of a bong hit?
No. I didn't smoke the drug, lady. I drank the drug, which gave my mind a backstage pass to the reality show. I'm going to bury it in the basement. Then I can finally say to Evil, hey, Evil, why don't you eat my butt?
Wonderful imagery. But it won't work if you just bury the book.
That's what my vision says.
Then your vision is stupid.
Yeah, you're right. It is kind of stupid. Almost as stupid as your stupid face.
Do you say one more dumb thing?
I'm gonna say a lot of dumb things. That didn't work.
Okay, okay, kids, break it up. All right, just everyone take a deep breath, okay?
Look, if the book is just buried like before, then some other fool like you can come along and use it. For the Necronomicon to be laid to rest, it has to be dismantled. Destroyed.
Impossible. Tried it.
With what, your pea shooter and your power saw?
Don't talk bad about Moe and Larry here. They've served me very well over the years.
Sure. They can kill the body that evil inhabits, but that spirit just keeps coming back, doesn't it?
Maybe.
Yeah. You see, the book and the evil that surrounds it really aren't affected by such things. Now, you gotta use it. The Kandarian dagger.
I know what that is.
Yeah, so why don't you show me the book? And we'll finally end this.
I gotta talk to my peeps. All right, guys. What do you think?
Okay, well, she did save our lives. And I think she smells kind of nice. Although, I haven't showered in a really long time, so I'm probably not the best judge.
I don't know. I mean, if I've learned anything from you, Ash, it's that if something seems too good to be true, it probably is. And also, she doesn't smell that nice.
Man, making decisions is so hard.
Let's look on the bright side. We balls deep in this shit. There's nowhere to go but up.
Yeah, up Shit's Creek.
Without a paddle.
Okay. You have to use the Kandarian dagger to deface the book. Literally, rip the face off the binding. And once you start, you cannot stop, no matter how difficult it gets.
Don't stop till the facelift is done. Got it. Okay, Book, it's gonna hurt you a lot more than it's gonna hurt me. Yeah, I forgot to mention, this thing has become quite the Chatty Cathy. Not for long.
Then the power of ownership will be mine, and the ritual will be complete.
Sounds simple enough.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Then why'd you stop?
Well, I don't know. It's just, should I say goodbye to it or what?
With the book defaced, time is of the essence.
Yeah, I got that. But after all we've been through?
Ash, you have carried this burden for 30 years. Isn't it time you let someone else take the load?
Just let her take your load, Jefe.
Just finish it.
Okay. Fine, sure. Yeah, take it.
Kurzai. Kumarisma. Kurzai.
Ishta demuchi
Akamana.
I don't think I like this.
There's something fishy with that book.
If they ask me, I could write a book about the way you walk and whisper and look. I could write a preface on how we met so the world would never
we let loose upon the world.
Oh, crap.
Stay back. Please.
I'm gonna die in here.
I'm coming for you.
It's the end of this episode, bud. The flesh of the book comes off and it shoots onto Pablo's face. At a certain point, you're just like, okay. If you're an actor on a horror show where people turn into deadites, it might be a little scary when the makeup person comes up to you and says, we have to mold your face, because it might make you think like, uh-oh. But I think we told Ray pretty quickly, and he was pretty psyched about it.
Help me!
Oh my God! Help me. Oh my God!
I spent a lot of days in that. I hope it was comfy. The Necronomicon takes on some personality of its own, and it can talk to Ash.
I'm what makes you special.
That was a practical effect. They actually built a book that could talk and sort of whisper to Ash.
You see how it works like this?
It's all part of this cabin and this place fucking with him. You know, it's also saying the things that he's thinking. If he gives up this life, what does he become? But I think it's an untrustworthy character to listen to.
Ash, if you bury me, you stop being a Superman and go back to being a stock boy.